But I would be remiss if I said I haven't taken the time to sit down and think about the last year. Think about the decisions that I've made. Were they the right ones? Were they the wrong ones? 365 days. 365 blank canvases. And what have I done? What have I become? And I realized I've become a work of art. Now stay with me here if you can. Say you go to a museum. I don't know if you people do that, but if you go to a museum and you see a famous Vincent van Gogh and you look at it, you stare at it in awe and you can't look away. And you may not understand the details, the nuances, the complexities, but it makes you feel. I make you feel, because that's what good art does. I make you feel. And the other thing about fine art is that it reveals the truth. So I'm standing here as WWE's Vincent van Gogh to let you know that, well, you're not gonna finally lose those last 10 pounds. You're not going to get that job promotion that you were always looking for. And you're not gonna finally get the hell out of South Carolina. Girls back there, they're not gonna finally win the Raw Women's Championship. And if you don't believe me, look no further than Liv Morgan. She swore to all of you that she was gonna win the Raw Women's Championship, and on the very first day of the new year, she broke her promise to herself and to all of you. And so that is...
Having witnessed that match firsthand, as we all did, Liv Morgan has nothing to be ashamed about.
Wow! New year, new ugly jacket, and same delusional Bex.
I like this jacket.
Oh, I don't. I don't think anyone does. But Bex, I was back there listening to you say how I came up short at day one. So let me tell you something. There is no one harder on me than myself. So please, please, you don't need to worry about me. But I was thinking, I know, and I know that you know, just how close I was to winning that title on Saturday. Yeah, but you did get one thing wrong, Becky. The only thing I ever promised myself from the moment that I was old enough to dream about being in a WWE ring is that I would give it my all and leave everything that I have in this ring every single time I got the chance to step in it. And that's exactly what I did at day one.
That's lovely and all, Liv. And maybe one day you might win the Raw Women's Championship, but that'll be when I retire. Because this isn't going anywhere. I'm holding on to this because this is what happens when you're big time, and there's only one big time, Bex, and it sure as hell ain't you.
I'm on my
own. I think someone else would like to join the Raw Women's Championship conversation.
EST has entered the chat.
Styling, holding like she can. Bianca Belair.
Oh, just like you ain't the EST or WWE. And you know what, Beck? I am sick and tired of hearing you come out here week after week acting like you untouchable. Look, Liv ain't buying your hype, and neither am I. And I don't trust you as far as I can throw you. Actually, that really doesn't make any sense, because you and I both know that I can throw you pretty damn far. Now, I may have taken a little dewdrop detour. You know, I graciously stepped aside. I stepped aside to allow, you know, other people time to catch up. But now, Bianca Belair, the EST of WWE. Oh, now I'm right back in line for big time bets.
No. Look. The two of you have just fallen victim to my routine. Beat, sleep, repeat. But hey, maybe the two of you can get together and do something constructive, you know, start a support group. We can talk about how, you know, you almost beat me, but you came up short. Oh, no, wait, hang on, that already exists. It's called the women's locker room.
What do you know? What do you know about the women's locker room, Beck? You haven't been in there in years. And you know what, Bianca? No offense, but Becky and I are kind of in the middle of something, so if you could please just maybe go to the back.
You know what, Liv? No offense taken. But at the end of the day, Becky and I got a score to settle that goes back way before yours.
Yeah. I mean, this is interesting and all, but it sounds like you guys got to figure this out one-on-one, and I've shared the spotlight enough for tonight, so why don't the two of you get the hell out of my ring and just decide who it's going to be, and let me know a bit later, okay?
Called for
a double team on big time Becks.
Did you really think Bianca Belair and Liv Morgan were just going to leave the ring?
Well, I hope maybe Liv Morgan or Bianca Belair had an ounce of class and wouldn't attack the Raw Women's Champion without cause.
Look at this face off.
Oh, they're going at it.
Belair and Morgan.
Both these ladies want the next opportunity at the Raw Women's Championship. Taking it to each other right now.
Oh, beautiful step-up shot by Liv Morgan.
Oh, Belair responds. Nasty shot. And now, Belair.
Making KOD.
And big time Becks from behind.
Taking advantage. No surprise there. Manhandle slam.
Well, deja vu for the EST.
That's just the way Becky Lynch wants it. She wants a spotlight all to herself with the Raw Women's title.
Well, if any other woman on the roster wants Becky Lynch's spotlight, they're going to have to step up and take it from her.
See the strategy, let your opponents fight one another. Smart move by Big Time Becks.
All right, Big Time Becks at the last lap.
Big Time Becky Becks!